All right, dear children of class 11 science, so we do continue solving the numerical problem. Now, in this video, we solve with problem number 2. So, we solve problem number 2, and this is also problem based on this work done and the potential energy. Okay, and problem says that a brass rod of length 0.2 meter. So, what is 0.2 meter? Is the length of the brass rod. So, let me just do the solution. Okay. And that is L. L means the length of the brass rod, original length, which is 0.2 meter. And area of cross section is 2 centimeter square. So area cross section means A, which is 2 centimeter square. But written this centimeter square, I'll convert into meter square. So what I do? I multiply by 10 to minus 4 meter square. So remember this part. To convert centimeter square to meter square, you have to multiply by 10 to minus 4. So this is the area of cross section of a bar, brass rod. And this brass rod is compressed by a force. By how much force the brass is compressed? 5 kg weight. So your force F is how much? 5 kg weight. So this is the compressed force. I use this word as a what? Compressed force. Compressed force. So this force, which is given in gravitational unit, but I convert into absolute unit. Means I write this force in Newton. So basically what I do, I multiply by 9.8. Actually 9.8 is the acceleration to gravity, which is not given, but we take the gravity, acceleration to gravity, average value is 9.8. So it will be 5 into 9.8 newtons. So I'll leave it like this only. So this is 5 into 9.8 newtons. So this is the compressed force. So this compressed force is applied on this much area. Okay. So definitely what happened? There is a what? Change in the what? There is a change in the length of the wire. Okay, there is a change in the length of the wire. So in this question, what you need to find out? Determine the increase in energy of the rod. So how much energy will be increased? Means the elastic potential energy you have to find out of the brass rod. And that elastic potential energy is actually we calculate in terms of the work done. To stretch, to compress the wire. Okay, compress the wire along the length. But in this question, Young's modulus of brass rod is given. Means brass rod Young's modulus is given, that is 1.4 into 10 to power 11 newton per meter square. So this is Young's modulus. Okay, now we have to find the increase in energy of the rod. Now the increase in energy of the rod means actually nothing but the elastic potential energy. Let me write down elastic. Okay, potential what? Energy of the compressed bar. Okay, you may use the word compressed bar is actually given by U, and the formula is same as work done, that is 1 by 2 into stress into strain into volume. Stress into strain into volume. Okay, now in this question we need to calculate stress. Even we have to calculate strain, and lastly we calculate the what? Volume. So to calculate the stress, you know stress means force by area. Now your force means this much, how much? 5 into 9.8. Now area that we have already calculated, that is 2 into 10 to the minus 4. So let me just divide 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8, 2 nines are 18. Okay, so your area which is coming as a stress which is coming as 5 into 4.9. Now this 10 to the power 4 I'll take in the minus 4 I'll take in the numerator, it will 10 to the power 4. Now 5 into 4.9, if you multiply with the calculator, it will be 24.5 into 10 to the power 4 newton per meter square. This is the stress. Now in the same time we have to calculate the strain, but strain can also be calculated in terms of Young's modulus, and the relation is since strain, so we calculate first strain, and strain means nothing but stress by Young's modulus, stress by Y, because Young's modulus means stress by strain, so the strain means stress by Young's modulus. Okay, so stress, how much? 24.5 into 10 to the power 4 divided by Young's modulus, which is 1.4 into 10 to the power 11. So this is 1.4. So now we can do the calculation of this. Okay, so if you do the calculation, the 24.5, if I divide by 1.4, with the help of calculator, you get approximately 17.5. into 10 4. Now 4, now if I take 11 in the numerator, minus 11, so 4 minus 11 means minus 7. Means we have simple falling exponent. And this is your strain. And children, you know strain has no unit, so it will be like this only. 17.5 into minus 7 is the strain. Now, after that we calculate the volume. Even we calculate the volume, and volume means actually area into length, the original length. The area into original length means the volume. So what is the area of cross section? 2 into 10 power minus what? 4. Your length is 0.2. Okay, so we can multiply 0.2 into 2 means 0.4 into 10 power minus 4, and the unit is meter cube. So this is your volume. So we know volume, we know strain, we know stress. Now I can put this value in this expression, and that measure the increase in energy, means the elastic potential energy of the rod. So children, we calculate now increase in elastic potential energy of the rod, which is U equals to half into stress. So I'm writing the formula again, stress into strain into what? Volume. So this is the formula. Okay, half into stress. Yes, we had already calculated the stress, and the stress actually it was 24.5 into 10 to the power 4. Strain also we calculated, and you know what is the value of strain that we calculated? 17.5 into 10 to the power minus 7, and volume also we calculated, that 0.4 into 10 to the power minus 4. Now we can divide 2 1 2, 2 2 4 with 0.2. Now 24.5, okay, into 17.5, okay, we can multiply. Okay, now when we do the calculation, means when I multiply 24.5 into 17.5 and 0.2, if you do multiply with the help of calculator, you get approximately 85.75. okay, into, now the 10 bases are there, so power 4 minus 7 minus 4, the plus 4 minus 4 means 0, and there the power is minus 7. So it will be 10 to the minus 7, and because this 10 to the power 4, 10 to the minus 4 power will cancel out. So 85.75 into 10 to the minus 7. But I write this answer in single digit. This is in 10 digit, I write the answer in single digit. Means I shift this decimal one number left. So it means it will be 8.575. Now remember this part, children, when there is negative power, and if you shift one number front decimal left, your power decreases by 1 only. It will be 10 to the power minus 6. Okay. Now this value can be even round off to 1 decimal place. So 575 means we can round up to 6. So this value of increase in energy of the rod is 8.6 into 10 to the power minus 6. Unit is what? Joule. So we can leave the answer this way also. Okay. So answer will be 8.6 into the power minus 6 joule. Because this value, which we have calculated in 3 decimal place, but we can round up and calculate approximately in 1 decimal place. It is 8.6 and minus 6 joule. So this is the answer of question number, or problem number 2. Now children, I'll solve last numerical problem, that is problem number 3. And this is the last numerical problem from the chapter elasticity also. Okay. And problem number 3, we are doing the solution of this problem number 3. Problem number 3 says that a metallic wire, you have a metallic wire, has a radius of 0.2 millimeter. Means your radius R means 0.2 millimeter. So I convert this radius millimeter into meter, which means 0.2 into 10 to the minus 3 meter. This is the radius of a wire. And you know, when a wire has a radius, then it has a cross-section area. Means cross-section area means A. And you know why wire cross-section area is always area equals to the area of circle. And the area of circle is what? Pi r square. So it will be 3.14 into radius is 0.2 into 10 to the minus 3 with whole square. So this is the what? This is the cross-section area of a what? Wire. The question says that how much force is required to have an increase of 0.2% of its length? Means we need to find this time the force. Means F we need to calculate. But in this question, Young's modulus is given. So Y is given 9 into 10 to the power of 10 newton per meter square. But the length will be increased by 0.2% of its length. 0.2% of length means you don't know the original length. So in this case, original length is not given. We have to find the increase in length. So what I do? I'll assume original length of a wire is L, capital L. So the increase in length, that is delta L, will be 0.2% of L. So this is 0.2% of L according to the question. It means 0.2 by 100 into L. So this is increase in length, original length. Now from here, we calculate the force. And the force will be calculated from the statement of Young's modulus. So in Young's modulus means stress by strain. Stress means force by area. Strain means original increase in length by original length. This is sorry, increase in length by what? Original length. So delta L by what? L. So I'll reciprocal. So Y equals to F into L, capital L, by A into delta L. So if Y equals to F into L by A into delta L, so from here I'll make F as the subject. If I make F as the subject, it will be A cross multiply Y into A into delta L by L. So this is the formula that we use to measure the force. And the force can be calculated by subtracting the value. So F, Y is 9 into 10 power 11. This is, 9 into 10 power 4. Actually, the value of Y is given 9 into 10 power 10. Sorry, this is 10. So sorry, please do correct. Is 9 into 10 to the power 10. Young's modulus is not very small, it is 10 to the power 10. So please do correct. 9 into 10 to the power 10 into 3.14, okay, into area means pi, 3.14, into 0.2 into minus 3 with whole square, that is radius square. Delta L means what? 0.2 into L divided by original length is L into, now this 100 will go in the denominator, which means this L and L cancel out. Now we can do the calculation. Now we can further simplify this. So 9 into 3.14, the 0.2 square means 0.04, into this 0.2 also we multiply, into 10 power, this is 10 power, and then 3 to the 6, so 10 power minus 6. So 10 power 10 minus 6 by 100, I can write 10 power 2. Now children, this quantity in the numerator, if you see, if you multiply, you can get the value approximately 0.22608. So I'm writing directly four quantities, if you multiply, you get 0.22608 into 10 minus 6 is what? 4, and 4 minus 2 is what? This is 4, okay, by 10 to the power 2, which means I can further simplify. Now 4 minus 2 means 10 to the power 2, so it will be 0.22608 into 10 to the power 2, which means if you multiply 0.22608 into 10 to the power 2 means 100, it will be 22.6. And I'm writing this answer in one decimal place. So how much force that is required to elongate the wire of 0.2% of its length means 22.6 Newton. So this is also one of the numerical based on the force that makes the body to stress. Okay, so three numerical problem I have solved. Okay, and with this numerical problem, this is the last numerical problem, of this particular chapter, elasticity.